India government is paying now 65,000 crores or more than that towards the subsidy for chemical fertilizers.
Yeah.
Why? If worldwide this natural farming is accepted, it is a lifestyle and it is very healthy food. And the food grain produced out of chemical fertilizer is creating different type of diseases in body. It is medically proved also. And you are also saying that. Yes. Why not India government is totally abolishing or rejecting this subsidy?
Thank you for your question. At the first, I have to clarify the differences between all technologies which are practiced in India since ancient days. Before chemical farming was launched in India, nobody farmer was telling that he is doing natural farming or organic farming. He was saying, telling that I am a farmer, I am doing farm. When chemical farming is launched in India by means of the slaughter system, and those farmers who started this practice, chemical farming practices, they started to say that we are doing chemical farming and we are chemical farmer. Since 10,000 years in India, the farming practices have continued. But before chemical farming, it was not a natural farming. It was not a organic farming, which was practiced since thousands of years. It was an ancient Indian farming. And basically what has happened, there are so many confusions. This ancient Indian farming in agriculture technology was launched by Lord Sri Krishna before 5,000 years, is based on cow dung manure. It is a beautiful farming technique, no doubt. But what I have taken the trials on this ancient technology of agriculture, I found that if you want beautiful result in the first year in ancient technology, you have to apply 18 cartloads per acre, that means 9 metric ton per acre FOM, cow dung manure, per acre every year. And if you want to utilize this 18 cartloads per acre FOM, you have to keep 10 cows, deshi cows. It is totally impossible, because if we will calculate, India has now 45 crore acre land for cultivation. If we want 10 cows for 1 acre, that means we want 450 crore cows we want. And now we have only 8 crore cows. That means in dream also it is not possible, totally impossible to practice ancient technology. Secondly, ancient technology of agriculture in India and abroad also, which is based on cow dung manure, it is very harmful for global warming and climate change. Because what are the greenhouse gases are emitted by means of the chemical farming and organic farming, even ancient technology also, they are emitted maximum quantity of the greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide. Because when you apply cow dung manure on the surface of the soil, and when temperature of the atmosphere will increase more than 28 degrees centigrade, the 46% carbon, that is organic carbon, which is existed in cow dung manure and also in compost and vermicompost, it start to release. And when the temperature is increased above than 36 degrees centigrade, entire carbon is released, combined with the oxygen in the atmosphere. By means of oxidation process, carbon dioxide is released and deposited in the atmosphere. Even simultaneously, at the same time, nitrous oxide also emitted and methane also is emitted. That means, you know, the main now the severe problem is global warming and climate change. And entire world media is thinking about how to protect the human being and entire environment from global warming, climate change, impact of the global warming, climate change. And if it is the fact, that means we have to give the alternate of ancient Indian technology, that is cow dung manure based technology. And for the, as a alternate, universal exporter system launched global chemical farming in India and abroad also, throughout the world. basically this chemical farming is based on energy consumption. The definition is that how much we will utilize maximum quantity of the energy, that country will be developed country. That means these energy sources are limited. They are not unlimited. In one day, it will be finished. Then how future generation will survive? So, by means of the chemical farming, there is a great hazardous impact. Now you have also told in your introduction, soil, environment, human being, human health, and the water also is totally polluted and finished at all. Not instead that we can utilize. For that purpose, it is very essential to give the alternate for chemical farming also. Later on, one entomologist from Japan, his name is Masanobu Fukuoka. He was with me for 2 days. We have discussed a lot of in 1996 also in India when he came. He has given one philosophy, do nothing. Do nothing means you have to sow the seed and cut down. And we have tried, lot of people tried, and they totally failed. Because when you will go to cut down, there was no crop, only grasses were there. That means Fukuoka also accepted this fact that it is not possible in India to adopt Fukuoka technology as it is. So we do not want natural farming also. We do not want natural farming also. As an alternative for natural farming, same exploded system which was launched chemical farming throughout the world to exploit natural resources and economies of those countries, same system has launched organic farming in throughout the world also. Because when we accepted our green revolution, our target was to be a self-sufficient in our food grain production. But that exploited system which has launched chemical farming in India and throughout the world, their hidden agendas were another hidden agenda. Number one, to exploit the economies of developing and developed countries, entire world, and second one, to destroy the natural resources. It has happened. It has happened. When any farmer will go to the cities to purchase hybrid seeds, genetically modified seeds, chemical fertilizer, chemical insecticide, tractor, and all other inputs, ultimately money will come from villages to the cities. In the cities, money will not remain, only commission will remain. Money will go again out of India by means of the multinational company who is the grower, producer of these inputs outside of India. That means I have calculated how much money we are losing every year, and I have calculated for hybrid seeds and genetically modified seeds, chemical fertilizer, chemical insecticides, organic fertilizer, organic insecticides, hybrid seeds, technology, and also tractor technology, foreign medicines, and foreign polyester clothes, and the technology, cosmetics. Why India is losing every year 54 lakh crore, 54 lakh crore. That means this is the great erosion of our Indian economy. And it happened because that exploitative system has established that system by which this erosion of the Indian economy is going on. We have to restrict this erosion. And only alternate, that is zero budget natural farming, by which we can restrict this erosion of the Indian economy. That same exploitative system has launched organic farming in India also. Organic farming is not Indian technology, basically. Organic farming is a foreign technology. It is not a Swadeshi technology. In organic farming, there are three inputs are given. Number one, compost technology, which is developed not in India, in Europe. Second one, vermicompost technology. It is not developed in India. It is developed in Europe. And third one, biodynamic. It is not developed in India. It is developed in New Zealand. That means, what are the inputs are given? Three inputs are given in organic farming. All are developed in foreign countries, in Europe, America, not in India. That means these are not Swadeshi, these are the Videshi. And even by means of the organic farming, number one, maximum greenhouse gases are emitted, which are responsible for global warming and climate change. Number two, nobody farmer is getting result in organic farming in the entire world. I am traveling throughout world, 24 days in a month. I have not seen single example that he is practicing organic farming is getting best result. No, not at all. Third one, organic farming inputs when utilized, you restrict the humus creation in the soil. Humus is the fertility of the soil. That means it is a pre-planned conspiracy to restrict the humus creation, that means fertility creation, and so that we, our soil will become barren and we will purchase inputs from the market. Ultimately, money from India will go to outside country. First, you have mentioned that organic farming, organic fertilizer, or that means compost. Compost very hazardous. Very hazardous for ecosystem. Because compost has 46% organic carbon, which is released when the temperature is increased above than 36 degrees centigrade. In May, June or April, March also, when the temperature is above than 48 degrees centigrade also sometime, entire carbon is released and it will deposit in the atmosphere by means of the carbon dioxide. It is a greenhouse gas. Number two, compost restrict the humus creation because compost is prepared outside the root zone, not near the root zone. Near the root zone, humus is created. In the factory, humus is not created. We want humus, we do not want compost. Number two. So, it is very wrong statement by those people who are propagating organic farming that they have to utilize all the straw of the paddy or any other crop for compost technology. It is totally wrong. We have to stop. Number two, the first, we have to utilize maximum straw to feed the animals, livestock animals, because we have deficit in straw production. It is the right of the animals, livestock animal, to get available the straw first. If the straw will available after feeding to the animal, then we have to utilize only straw mulching on the surface of soil, not for composting. Because those soil microorganisms which create the humus in the soil, they want microclimate. Without microclimate, they can't survive, they can't activate. And this microclimate is created in the soil and above the soil by when you mulch the straw on the surface of the edge mulching. That means what is the straw is available, it is to be utilized only for a mulching, not for compost, vermicompost at all. Number two, this straw also is to be utilized not only for mulching, we have to utilize for future crop also. It should be stored for future crop. If we will utilize entire straw in your first crop, then it will not available in the future because climate change and environmental changes are very severe now. Drought condition has very become severe, and in future there will be great deficit of the straw. We have to store. And since ancient days, the farmer were producing three times more straw. One third was utilized in the first year, one third was utilized for next year, one third was utilized for drought condition. That is totally finished. So it is very hazardous that entire straw to be utilized in the first year. And secondly, it is not necessary at all, not necessary at all. In Japanese method of rice cultivation, the water is dumped in the soil. And when water is dumped in soil, it is totally impossible to utilize straw as a mulching. Totally impossible, because straw will float and it will not touch to the soil. It is very essential, straw should be touched to the soil. So in coastal area where there is a Japanese method, and I think that in entire India now there is a Japanese method of rice cultivation, it is totally impossible to utilize straw for mulching. So better way to utilize maximum straw by rotavate the straw, residues of the previous crop, by means of the rotavator in the soil, so that the maximum quantity of organic carbon will be deposited in the soil, and that carbon when will give the nitrogenous straw material to incorporate in the soil, that means residues of the pulses, even when we'll dibble the seeds of the cowpea, drumstick, pigeon pea on the boundary of the rice field, then the nitrogen will fix, and that this carbon and nitrogen will get together, and humus will be created, and future crop and in present crop also will be benefited. So it is very essential to utilize maximum straw for first to the cow. Number two, we have to store, preserve the straw for future year and drought condition. Number three, we have to incorporate residues of the straw in the soil. And number four, not to be utilized for compost technology.
He's dancing now. Dr. Fukuoka has not mentioned anything about the cows in his one-star revolution. Because bars, about bars also, hence he has mentioned pig chelchi, because he had no cows. Dr. Fukuoka has not mentioned about anything about cow. Perhaps he had no cows. He had mentioned about hen, pigs and others here in Japan, he has kept it. But anyway, coming to the right point, but universally it is now proved chemical fertilizer is dangerous to atmosphere, to soil, to water resources and human body.
Who has accepted?
This
fact is not accepted by the government, this fact is not accepted by the agricultural universities, and even this fact is not accepted by the decision makers.
But can you not mobilize the agriculturalists and some universities, as you are quite innovative in your idea and very much powerful.
So
India government first should ban chemical fertilizer, whether it will ban or not. But it should not give any subsidy, huge amount of crores of rupees of subsidy for chemical fertilizer. Do you think it is a conspiracy? That why government of India is spending from the revenue, this nation's money, some 65,000 crores every year. And it is given to fertilizer companies only, not to the farmers. Fertilizer companies, who will count that fertilizer, this much of fertilizer utilized or not? Whatever the fertilizer companies are giving the view, and according to they are getting the, and there is one portfolio also, there is one minister also for that.
Yeah.
Why it is not banned? Huge amount of expense.
Yeah, that is your question is really right question. Your question is very wise question, I think that. There are some facts I would like to share with you. Number one, the mother of Green Revolution, Pantanagar Agricultural University. Because from Pantanagar Agricultural University, Uttarakhand, Green Revolution is started and spread out in India. In this year, Pantanagar Agricultural University invited me to give the one-day workshop in university. Total hall was totally packed. All the HODs, all scientists, all professors and scholars were present in my workshop. They listened full day. At last evening, they accepted that now we have to change the policy. And then they have accepted that they will start the comparative studies of chemical, organic and zero-budget natural farming. That means they are thinking now. They are thinking. In future, they will take decision, I don't know. What is the impact on the mentality of the university, I don't know. Whether they are listening government, I don't know. Who is giving the suggestion to them, I don't know. But I am sure one day the people will pressurize the government and even agricultural universities. Number two, we do not want any certificate from agricultural university. We want certificate from those farmers who are practicing zero-budget natural farming. When they are happiest and happy face is the best certificate, I think that. Number two, every government is under pressure that they have to reduce the subsidy for chemical fertilizer. Because World Trade Organization is pressurizing continuously to all governments. When you we signed Dunkirk draft, we have given the legal commitment to reduce the subsidy. And government of India has reduced a lot of subsidy from 1,40,000 crore, now 80,000 crore, now 64,000 crore. That means they are legally bounded, no doubt. But there is no speed at all. Maybe some reason. Mr. Radha Mohan Ji, he is the Central Agriculture Minister. We have discussed in New Delhi, and I have suggested him. He read my books also. I have suggested him that we are not going to pressure you that you have to ban chemical and organic, because none of the government can decision immediately. There is a long process. Even it is to be discussed on the Lok Sabha, the Parliament also. It is a decision, but we will give the suggestion. Please, you select one village from one block in entire India, and one taluka, you select one village, and you select only 10 farmers for zero budget natural farming, one from one village. That means, and let it to continue policies. All the farmers, rest of the farmers can practice chemical, organic, you have no hesitation. But you prepare new cell, you start a new cell in your ministry, and only that cell will mobilize zero budget natural farming throughout India. We do not want single rupee from Indian government, because zero budget natural farming do not want any input. Myself, I do not take single rupee as an onerium. I am liberating my 25 days in a month, continuous workshop. I do not take single rupee. Nobody, my cousin people and my assistant people, these started this movement, they do not take single rupee. That means we do not want any single rupee from government. If they want to practice zero budget natural farming in small scale, they have not to provide in budget, because nothing is required for this technology. So it is very easy to take the decision by the government of India.
That also I am saying.
Yeah. Taken any decision by the Indian government yet.
Right.
Why? I don't know.
That I am saying, that everybody knows.
The batting change.
Everybody knows that chemical fertilizer is produced out of coal, naphtha gas and petroleum.
Yeah.
And these are non-renewable energies. Once finished forever. So much of wealth is lost. The soil is polluted, the water resources is polluted, human body is polluted, and every diseases are coming. That it is becoming late. But why not you are organizing the scientists, like-minded people,
That
for to take the hectic decision, immediate decision, that governments of India should ban chemical fertilizer immediately, and should be banned, and should save them from 64,000 crores.
I think that as a journalist, you have to ask them, you have to suggest government of India. I think that media should pressurize the government. Media can do it.
But media doesn't understand
I
know.
But in future, there is a great danger. Because what are the raw materials? Just you have mentioned the naphtha and natural gases is required for urea production. For phosphatic fertilizer, phosphogypsum is required, phosphoric acid is required. And now, phosphoric acid stock is totally going to finish. Naphtha and natural gases stock are going to finish. That means within 10 years, none of the chemical fertilizer will be available in the market. And chemical farming, hybrid seeds and genetically modified seeds are giving production when you utilize fertilizer. If you will not utilize fertilizer, they will not give the production at all. That means it is very essential to utilize chemical fertilizer with the genetically modified seeds, even with the hybrid seeds. And when chemical fertilizer will not available in the market, automatically chemical farming will be stopped, and genetically modified seed utilization will be stopped, and some hybrid seeds utilization will be stopped. And as a pre-planned conspiracy,
how speedily the local seeds are finished as a pre-planned conspiracy. At that time, no single gram of the local seed will be available. What future generation will sow in the soil? This is a great danger, conspiracy. So I will suggest to government, to media, to NGOs, and even to social organizations, spiritual organizations, they have to start this movement to collect the local seeds where there is available and to give the available to the farmers. It is to be a big movement, and we have started. Our 10,000 farmers who are senapatis in Zero Budget Natural Farming Movement, they are my associates. They are going into tribal people, they are collecting the local seeds and they are multiplying, and we are giving available to the farmers. But we are limited resources. We do not take single rupee as a honorarium. We do not take any funds from any funding agency. So we have limitations. But those who have not limitation, they can start this local seed collection movement. I think that, and you media people can start this movement by means of the media also. In media, in electronic media.
Sir. As you admitted that this is a conspiracy for hybrid seeds and also chemical fertilizer. So that is proved also. But who is the kingpin of this conspiracy? Who is the leader of the? To whom you have to blame? To you?
Nobody is leader. Nobody is leader of this conspiracy who has launched chemical farming throughout the world. Nobody is leader of this conspiracy, green revolution, and even organic farming, which are launched in throughout the world, because these two technologies, chemical farming and organic farming, are launched by that universal exploiter system which is not visible. It is invisible, because common farmer, when he will purchase hybrid seed, genetically modified seed, chemical fertilizer, chemical insecticide, tractor, or even organic inputs also from the market, the money will come from his pocket to the system, and it will go to system. That means even utilizer farmer also a member of the system, export system. He is exploiting himself. He is exploiting natural resources, and even he is exploiting himself. That means this is the invisible system. American president is not the president of the system. Indian prime minister is not a president of the system. Even multinational companies president, chairman also is not a part of this chairman of this system. Each system is invisible system. Everybody who purchases anything from the market which is not required even, and which will destroy the natural resources, is the member of that ecological system. I think that he is the king of the system.
But do you not blame this? Will you not blame these multinational companies or new economic system which are introducing and when you are propagating this innovative way of natural farming?
Zero budget natural farming. No, it is totally different. Natural farming and natural farming.
No money is, even farmers' money is not spent. Even nobody's money is spent. Everybody is safe. Food grain is safe. Our health is safe. Why our intellectuals and agriculture scientists, they are not accepting it? So far, so early they will accept it, so good. Because it is becoming late.
Beautiful question you have asked. Basically, we have started non-violent, non-communal, constitutional movement. We are not against anybody. Even the producer companies of chemical fertilizer, tractor, chemical insecticide, and hybrid seed, genetically modified seeds, are also a member of this, our movement. mass movement, zero budget, natural farming, or spiritual farming movement. Even Agricultural Institute Vice Chancellor and even the scientists are also a member of this our movement. Even seller of the inputs of chemical farming and organic farming are also a member of this movement. Even government also is a member of this movement. MNC is also a member of the movement. Because every part of the society is not willing to die with the cancer. They are not willing to die with the high diabetes and heart attack. And they are well known by means of the media awareness that these hazardous diseases, just like diabetes, heart attack and cancer, is developed and is committed by means of the polluted environment, polluted water and poisonous food material. And they know this poisonous food material and polluted water and environment is given by chemical and organic farming. They want chemical free, organic free, naturally grown food material. Otherwise they can't survive. That means we are giving available to these all peoples who are the promoters of chemical and organic farming. They are the basic principles of this system. We are giving poisonous food them, pollution free environment them, pollution free water to them to survive them. We are giving assistance to them to survive. So we are not enemy and they are not our enemy.
That was also, that pollution free energy, that was also propagated and told by non-violent agriculture, by father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi. He was himself implementing it in Wardha farm. But why this nation forgot the father of the nation and Gandhi?
Not only nation, Gandhiwadi also has forgotten to Gandhiji. When I traveled throughout the world, young generation from foreign countries and India also asking one question to me. Sir, you are from India, Gandhiji is India. We want to visit one ideal model which is based on Gandhian principle. No one single village is established by these Gandhian people yet on the Gandhian principles, not yet. They have given long lectures, they have given long speeches, they have given long articles. No Gandhian people is interested to establish the village, even single village, and in entire world which is based on Gandhian philosophy. Though this is a tragedy. This is a tragedy. So we are not expecting anything from Gandhian people. I think that.
Also, your method is also, I will tell that it is divine method. It is spiritual.
Yeah.
So I think ultimate end is God. We have to believe that when God will wish, then this is natural farming and spiritual farming will be implemented, because it is so vicious. The conspiracy is so very cruel and all this, because everybody is running after profit and money. So how to you think in this condition it will take how many days or years to be your idea, your dreams, your innovative system will be implemented in India, at least in India. Not may not be in third world or not be in Asia and Africa totally, but in India at least, when the government and the scientists and the farmers are now accepting it gradually, but it is very slow, because this it is so dangerous now. The pollution is so heavy and so vast that everybody is thinking of this, but there is no way out. So you are taking how much?
That is correct. We are not hurry. We are not hurry. It will take time, which is fixed by the God, not by human being. Number one, which is fixed by the situation in the future, not by human being. Number one. Number two, we are not reacting any system. We are not fighting to this exploited system. Not at all. Not at all. We are establishing our parallel system, and that is happened. It is established. We will increase the dimension of this our own parallel system. We will not lose our energy to fight the system, that exploited system. We will utilize all the energy to establish our own parallel system. And we are successful. We are successful. Mass movement, which was started by the consumer area, will pressurize the university and governments to rethink about their policies. The mass movement will pressure the government and the system. We will not pressurize the system, because future time will take the decision. And number two, when any farmer will take the decision to purchase hybrid seed, genetically modified seed, chemical fertilizer, insecticide and tractor and all inputs, this decision is taken by him. There is no law in the Constitution of India that you have to purchase chemical inputs, otherwise you will be fined, you will be hanged. No single law in the Indian Constitution. That means there is no any is under pressure, constitutional pressure. Everybody can take decision his own. That means when any farmer take decision to purchase chemical inputs and organic inputs, this decision is taken not by government, not by MNCs, not by system. This decision is taken by him himself. And even he has not taken his decision, there is a chandal chaukadi inside him, that is kama moha lobha trishna, that means unsaturated desire, and that unsaturated desire has taken the decision. That means it is not an outer battle, it is inside battle, and this inside battle, kama lobha moha trishna, will be controlled not by weapons, not by lectures, not by speeches. It is only to be controlled by only the spirituality, and that is the correct answer, I think, that to your question.
In India, there are so many spiritual organizations, so many monks, sadhus and all this, but I have visited all these ashrams and all this.
Yeah, yeah.
I found only in Pondicherry ashram, by the initiation of Srima, this natural farming is implemented in their Gloria farm, 100 acres of here.
Yeah, yeah,
and mother was taking there to only produce food that
day. I have visited.
But other ashrams, hospital, maybe Sivananda ashram or Ramana ashram, which I have visited. Even Gandhi ashram, Vinoba ashram, all these, nowhere it is practiced. This natural or organic, you say, natural. How will you say?
No, I think that you have asked this question to wrong person. I am not a correct person. You have to ask this question to ashramas people, who are the ashram manager. You have to ask ashram rishis, ashram santas, ashram babas, why they have not started zero budget natural farming, why they are against this technology, why they have not thought about it. This question to be asked by you to those people, not to me.